history, most remarkable women had to fight to be seen or heard.
There's an awful lot of work that needs to be done, and I think it does have to be done by women to help other women.
But not now.
Don't let anyone define you. You define yourself.
Diversity in race and gender is not a trend. It's a movement.
Now, high above Hollywood, where dreams really do come true, atop the luxurious Loews Hotel, a shout out to all the fierce females.
Next hour, all 201 Nexstar owned and or operated television stations band together to amplify the voices of today's unsung heroes.
Some of the biggest names in show business salute remarkable women from around the country.
Women who are open-minded, who are hardworking, who are professional.
I think a remarkable woman is a woman that is just living in her truth.
Remarkable people and remarkable women are people who move the dial, who are able to see what is needed and make it happen.
As Nexstar Nation gets ready to name 2024's Remarkable Woman of the Year,
welcome to Hollywood!
A purple carpet welcomes 112 trailblazers and changemakers who earned the remarkable title in their cities across America.
I'm ready to be pampered. I'm a mom of six, so this doesn't happen in my life very often.
Because I'm so grateful. It's so amazing to be recognized for your passion and all the hard work you do for so long. Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay.
You guys overwhelm me with so much gratitude I have toward you.
We're not used to it because we don't do any of the stuff we do for accolades, right? I mean,
right.
We just do it because it's who you are. You think it's the right and the best thing, the great thing to do for somebody else. So
it's in your heart to do.
My name is Perry Sook, and I am the founder, chairman, and CEO of Nexstar Media Group. This year, Nexstar's local television stations received nearly 10,000 nominations. And today, there are 112 of you being recognized here. To celebrate your dedication and community service, Nexstar will donate $1,000 each to the nonprofit of your choice. Over the last 4 years, the Nexstar Media Group has proudly donated nearly $500,000 to charities across the country in honor of remarkable women. The 2024 winner will be announced shortly, and Nexstar will donate $10,000 to her charity of choice. Congratulations.
Who will be named Nexstar's next Remarkable Woman of the Year? Coming up, some remarkable surprises. Join Lisa Gibbons, Jennifer Hudson, and many more as Hollywood's biggest stars honor the amazing accomplishments of America's most inspiring women. And one woman will be named Nexstar's Remarkable Woman of the Year. Don't miss the celebration.
McIntyre, and congratulations to all the remarkable women.
Congratulations to all of the remarkable women.
Kelly Clarkson, congratulations to all of you remarkable women.
From the entertainment capital of the world, welcome back to Nexstar's Remarkable Women.
New light inside, so alive on this high we're living on.
It's just such an incredible experience so far. You know, these women are so inspiring.
The energy here is amazing. It's like meeting people that you've always known.
We have a lot of things planned for us. I'm looking forward to all of it.
I have not been to Hollywood before.
Everybody's greeting me with a smile. It is gorgeous here. I don't think I want to go home.
For you and I, this is our dream. Now the
feel fabulous. Thanks to all of you. This is a wow.
I am remarkable from Hollywood, California.
These women are so amazing. They have taken some of the most difficult circumstances from those in their own lives and those in their communities, and they've turned them into something really special that makes a difference for others.
Welcome, remarkable women, to the legendary TCL Chinese Theatre on the historic Hollywood Walk of Fame. Pretty epic, right? I'm Cher Calvin, and look around, the world's biggest stars have sat right where you are. And we know you don't do what you do for fame, but today these iconic curtains open to honor and celebrate your remarkable achievements. Who will be named Nexstar's Remarkable Woman of the Year? There are five finalists, and we want you to get to know all of them. So we're going to show their stories on TCL's big screen right now. Are you ready? Our first finalist from the Bronx, New York, Gerilyn Rodriguez. Gerilyn Rodriguez is determined to download change from artificial intelligence to innovations like ChatGPT. There is no doubt technology is the wave of the future. But are women, minorities, and low-income communities plummeting into today's so-called digital divide?
South Bronx is one of the most impoverished neighborhoods in the entire country. I grew up with my older sister and my mom. My dad was not around. I didn't actually realize that I was poor until I got to high school. I went to a private school on a scholarship, and it was the first time that I realized, wow, there are people that are in this school and they have so much more than I do. I was interviewing for Yale, which I didn't get in, but it's okay because I went into Columbia, and it was the first time that I learned for low-income communities, less than 10% of us make it to and through college. What happens to the rest of the 90%? And I kind of became obsessed with that statistic. My name is Gerilyn Rodriguez, and I am remarkable. A lot of people do grow up in the Bronx. They grow up hearing that once you're successful, you should leave. My approach is the complete opposite. I want to be successful, and I want to stay to give back to my community. So I started the Knowledge House with my co-founder almost 10 years ago. The Knowledge House is a nonprofit that provides code and design job training to young adults, primarily from low-income communities. And we are headquartered in the South Bronx.
Honestly, I knew I had more potential. I wanted to do something in technology. There was just no path.
The main goal is to place our young students either into college, an internship, or a full-time job in tech, where they are making a lot of money to uplift their families out of poverty and enough money to say, you know, I have contributed to my community's economic mobility.
Gerilyn, being from the same, not even the same neighborhood, the same building, and knowing that she created something so great, like the Knowledge House, that I can see myself following her path, but having something positive in my life was very crucial that I needed, because there wasn't a lot of positive influences growing up.
Gerilyn is remarkable because of her vision of wanting to make tech an equitable place for all people, women, people of color.
Opportunity and access are priceless, right?
What I have seen with the Knowledge House is that the vision of wanting to educate and equalize kind of the societal inequalities has stayed consistent.
Average salary for a Knowledge House graduate that is in a full-time job is $85,000. It is life-changing. When you go from $14,000 to $85,000, you're talking about taking care of yourself, your siblings, your parents,
your children.
I graduated and ultimately was able to land an interview with Bloomberg. I didn't like just pass interviews, I excelled in the interviews. So once I got the job offer, it feels like a weight is lifted off my shoulders now. The Knowledge House is remarkable.
At the end of the day, we're trying to alleviate poverty, right? Who knows if the Knowledge House is gonna fix poverty within my lifetime at least. But I have a lot of hope because we're literally mobilizing an entire community of young leaders that are gonna pick up where I leave off.
Geralyn, we think that you have cracked the code. Thank you. From Salina, Kansas, Heidi Fireherm Smith, when it comes to comforting kids with cancer, this mom is not monkeying around. After her daughter's deadly diagnosis, a broken heart fueled this remarkable woman's mission.
So let's get some kit components here. Okay. Do you want to take this to the other room? The Love Chloe Foundation was founded in 2008 in memory of Chloe Fireherm. We serve families in Kansas as well as all across the United States with our Monkey in My Chair program, and we just help families that have a child diagnosed with cancer.
June of 2022, Arabea was diagnosed with B-cell leukemia.
In February of 2023, they found a tumor in her spinal column. It was diagnosed as a ganglioglioma.
There's about 15,000 childhood cancer diagnoses every year in the US. It's about 46 children every single day. Chloe was born in March of 2000. She was my millennial baby. She was happy, healthy, just regular kid. She loved to sing and dance. And unfortunately, in November of 2006, she was diagnosed with DIPG at 6 years old. And that is a diffuse intrinsic pontine glioma, which essentially is cancer in her brainstem.
What do you think of her snowman?
Dude, I like the eyeballs.
Okay, and stuff them in there. So one of the things that was really important to us is when Chloe was first diagnosed, she was given a bear, and the bear can go to school and take her place in the classroom. Her friends would put notes and pictures and stuff. Chloe really felt like she was still there, in that she was still being represented in the classroom and her friends hadn't forgotten about her. I knew that something like that could be really beneficial for families, but I knew it needed to be a monkey. Chloe loved monkeys. Everything was all about monkeys.
We have Loews is our monkey's name, and he's been with Hayden since first grade.
Hi, I'm Ashley, and we're the Baloo family. Our son Hayden was diagnosed in January of 2016 with acute lymphoblastomic leukemia. The Love Chloe Foundation has definitely been one of our cornerstones for our family. They have helped us with different grants. I've had to quit my job both times that Hayden was sick.
We don't just fund our Monkey in My Chair program, but we also help families financially. We also do what we call a warrior wagon. It's a big canvas wagon, and we fill it with snacks and travel activities. We also do gas cards. So we have what we call fueling the fight.
She's pretty much like a second mom to me. From how much she checked up, and every time we'd come in, she'd pretty much ask me or make sure if I needed something.
There's days where I'll be driving and, you know, something, you know, memory or something will just kind of overcome. And you just kind of stop, and it's hard. But then I, you know, pick myself up, and I know that, like, I can do this. Everything I do is I think she would be proud of it. I think that she would be smiling at me.
We love Chloe Foundation.
I'm Heidi Fireherm Smith, and I am a remarkable woman.
Everybody, Heidi.
we all stand for the Monkey in My Chair program. Coming up.
Welcome to the Happy Place, ladies.
Some remarkable surprises.
Say hello to the woman, the legend herself, Sheila E. in the house for Remarkable Women. So qualities I think that make up a remarkable woman, I like a strong, bold woman. I like one that has opinions, her own independent thoughts.
My motto I live by was when my mom said my whole life, which was know who you are, be who you are, and stick with it no matter what.
This is Lonnie Love. Congratulations to all the remarkable women.
Champions, trailblazers, and everyday heroes, remarkable women from coast to coast take over Hollywood. Unlike other Hollywood award ceremonies, you are all winners. And to celebrate your remarkable achievements, Nexstar Charitable Foundation will donate $1,000 to the nonprofit of your choice. And that is a total of $112,000 to better our local communities. Tonight, a national winner will be named. 2024's Remarkable Women winner will also receive $10,000 for her nonprofit of choice. Are you ready? Now, another finalist. From Charlotte, North Carolina, Donna Lee Reed. For most kids, 18 marks a milestone of a birthday, but for the approximately 25,000 children aging out of foster care, blowing out those candles can signal a life up in smoke.
We are in Charlotte, North Carolina with Home for Me, a voice for teens in foster care. Home stands for hope, opportunity, mentoring, and education. Many are unaware of what is happening with our young people that are in the system. When they get moved and the average time is around six times, they lose connection.
Kids are raped, brutalized, bullied.
From 13 to 15 years old, our young people know pretty much they're not going to be adopted. 16 years old, the weight of the world starts weighing on them because at 17, they have 365 more days and they're done. Black trash bag syndrome. When they age out on their 18th birthday, their resources come to an end. They come with a black garbage bag and they tell them to get their stuff together. But now you're even equating me to garbage, to trash, something you throw away. Imagine what that feels like. So we need at least 120 bed in a bag. We make sure that they're brand new suitcases that are donated. We fill them with an umbrella, with sheets, with towels, with gift cards, and resources. I knew what it was like to be 18 years old with nothing. My biological mother left me in the hospital. She knew she couldn't take care of me. They placed me into white homes as an infant. They discover, wait a minute, she's not white. And so I end up in an orphanage until my mother, who raised me, gets me out of an orphanage. I faced alcohol, drugs, rape, abuse. I faced all of that after I aged out. I stood there at 18 years old, disconnecting from everything I knew. And I remember vowing to myself that there was anything I could ever do for a young person or aged out of foster care, I want to be able to do it.
M-I-L-A-N.
Milana Malia.
M-A-L-I-A.
Are not my biological children. So for them to see how remarkable of a woman Donna was and how resilient she's been from being in an orphanage to them also being displaced, Donna allows them to see that their dreams can be reality.
I think she's remarkable because she has a similar background to me and my sister. She is also remarkable because she's kind and she's like a good grandma.
We're trying to be the solution to what they're going through so that they themselves can stand up to you 10 years from now, 5 years from now, standing in their truth.
College, community, corporate, church, together we win for our young people.
And saying, if it had not been for home for me, I would have never graduated.
And we don't want them to ever think less of themselves. We don't ever want them to think of, I got tossed away. Because no, somebody loves you. I am Donna Lee Reed, and I am a remarkable woman.
Donna denounces the term foster child and encourages calling the young adults simply kids. Donna, our wish is your wish. Comes true. And meet another finalist. From Pasadena, California, Anna Estevez. Parents are supposed to be the very people who love, provide for, and protect their children. Yet the FBI reports an average of 450 children are murdered every year by their mother or father. Now, in the wake of her five-year-old son's murder at the hands of his father, a remarkable woman fights to change the law that could help stop the incomprehensible family murder known as filicide.
Hi, I'm Anna Estevez. We are here in South Pasadena, California at Garfield Park. The bench that I'm sitting on is a bench named after my son, Peaky. When he died, he was 5 years, 2 months, and 2 days old. He was and is the love of my life.
Anna doesn't give up. We had 5 years of Peaky, so she's fighting for Peaky's memory, and she's fighting for other families.
There's a lot of work to be done. There's a lot of injustice happening on a daily basis. Judges are failing children every single day. At the time, I didn't know that was the last time I'd see my son, or touch my son, or hug my son. I put the camera on my dashboard because at that point, I was very afraid for my safety. I had requested restraining orders from the judge in family court, two which were denied. Ara had taken him to Disneyland on that day. Ara wanted to give Peaky the best last day of his life. After they left Disneyland, Peaky was asleep in his car seat. He was strapped in. His father got his sweater and covered his face with his sweater and suffocated him while he was asleep. And Ara drove about 2 hours to Santa Barbara County and dumped Peaky's body in a heavily wooded area. He went to Las Vegas. He spent several weeks in Las Vegas. He was partying, taking drugs. He went skydiving. He was seen with prostitutes. 71 days. My son was missing for 71 days before his father confessed to murdering him.
You are a failure as a father. You are a failure as a man. And you are a failure as a human being.
Courts are there to serve the people. And in my case, family court destroyed a family. My son died. I am sentenced to a life without my son, and my ex-husband is in prison. Peaky's law took several years to pass. It mandates the Judicial Council to establish a training program for judges that focuses on domestic violence, coercive control, child physical and sexual abuse, the cycle of violence.
Anna, you are remarkable.
When I look in the mirror, I don't see a remarkable woman. I see a mom who loves and misses her son.
Anna says every child protected by Peaky's law keeps his spirit alive, and our Peaky promise we will not forget. Coming up, more inspiring stories. Plus, Jennifer Hudson, host of The Jennifer Hudson Show, with a remarkable surprise.
Every year, Nexstar Media Group has a nationwide campaign to celebrate remarkable women. Today, 112 of those remarkable women are here in my happy place.
Huge congratulations to all the remarkable women. I am so proud of you and so excited to see what we all do next.
Congratulations to all the remarkable women out there.
I would really hope that we're a team in this world and that this world as a whole becomes a team sport.
Confident women achieving incredible things. Some of the biggest names in show business salute remarkable women from around the country. Their names may not be in lights, but these 112 women are our country's true stars. We are remarkable! Nexstar's next remarkable finalist. Tammy Lang Campbell calls Houston, Texas home. You're a finalist! Oh my God. I hope you got that on camera.
Tammy Campbell is a pint-sized powerhouse with a big afro.
She's not just an activist, but she's an advocate. I remember when Tammy's standing in a cemetery and she represented the fact that we're gonna bury the N-word.
I call her Tammy. She's helped a lot of people. She has fuzzy hair.
I am a remarkable woman.
The Honey Brown Hope Foundation is a nonprofit organization. It's been in existence for over 30 years. We address civil rights advocacy, the school to prison pipeline, to criminal justice reform, to post-convictions issues.
I was unlawfully stopped during a traffic stop, and the police officer tried to kill me. He kept his knee on my neck for a little over 7 minutes. I remember thinking, who here in Houston would care about me? She was the first donor to my legal fees. And I remember her telling me that things would be all right. Tammy, Mama Campbell, you are more than remarkable.
I care about everyone as if they are my children.
Mama Campbell is her name in a community. It's something that she is revered. It's a spirit. But our mom was Tammy. Her first ministry was her home.
You're a remarkable mama.
Honey Brown Hope Foundation name came from looking at my beautiful brown baby girl and not being able to find a book that sent a message to her about her beauty.
And she said, you know what? Snow White's author has done a wonderful job of encouraging girls who are Caucasian, but you're not Snow White. She was looking in a cabinet and she saw some honey. And she said, you know what? You're beautiful, you're brown, you're honey brown.
Unfortunately, black and brown students are targeted for minor school infractions and treated as criminals. And that's what my baby went through at the tender age of 5.
I was in kindergarten and I had an incident where a police officer brutalized me in the classroom.
So what she did is she created a toolkit, and it took 30 years. What she's learned through activism
is called How to Advocate for Your Child for Black and Brown Parents, and it's in English and Spanish. We work from the schoolhouse to the jailhouse. Many people, I don't even know how they got my names or my number, but they like calling me day and night.
Tammy, you are remarkable.
Mama Campbell hopes everyone discovers their own Honey Brown and encourages today's youth to be the hero of their own unique story. Yes, yes, yes. Today's Hollywood Takeover is just getting started.
Extra, extra. Hello, Nexstar's 2024 Remarkable Women. Right now we have buses waiting outside, and you're all invited to be our personal guest to visit the legendary Warner Brothers Studios.
Today, our audience is filled with 112 women being honored by Nexstar's Remarkable Women Initiative. They came to the Warner Brothers Studio for a tour, but they had no idea that they would end up on my show in my audience, y'all.
Coming up.
Are you surprised, ladies? Yeah.
Fierce female Jennifer Hudson with a remarkable surprise. Join Hollywood's biggest stars as we honor the achievements of America's most inspiring women and find out who is Nexstar's Remarkable Woman of the Year. Jennifer Hudson, host of The Jennifer Hudson Show, with a remarkable surprise as we find out who is Nexstar's Remarkable Woman of the Year.
Today, our audience is filled with 112 women being honored by Nexstar's Remarkable Women Initiative. Every year, Nexstar Media Group has a nationwide campaign to celebrate remarkable women. They came to the Warner Brothers Studio for a tour, but they had no idea that they would end up on my show in my audience. Take a look at what happened when I surprised them earlier. Welcome to the Happy Place. Five of them have made it into the semifinals, and guess what? They have no idea that I am going to interview them right now, y'all. Come on down, ladies. What would it mean to each of you if you receive that reward?
So for Home for Me, it would mean that we would be able to reach more young people so that they can move with dignity.
This would just help us to be able to serve even more, and just the awareness that it brings to childhood cancer.
So this year, the Knowledge House turns 10. Winning $10,000 during the 10-year anniversary would be amazing.
I hear you.
We need to continue to educate the public on family court reform, to provide resources for victims.
First thing we would do is a hallelujah dance.
All right.
Hey. Derail the school to prison pipeline.
Thank you, ladies, for your passion, for your testimonies. Keep up the amazing work in everything you're doing. You inspire me, and you're gonna inspire so many others. You are remarkable, y'all.
Remarkable women, it's time to party. Raise the roof for DJ Miss Ninja. Holding the mic for the night, your remarkable MC, Emmy Award-winning host, Lisa Gibbons.
This is a movement. It's a movement being fueled by each of you, 112 superstars who dare to care more, work harder, work longer, work better to make a difference and to make a mark on humanity.
Tonight, Nexstar celebrates remarkable women. I'm pleased to introduce you to the most remarkable woman in my life, my partner, my advisor and counselor, and my best friend, my wife of over 42 years, Dr. Sandy Sook.
By now, you know the purpose of this initiative is to honor the influence that women had on public policy, social progress, the quality of life, and to celebrate local women who inspire, lead, and forge the way for other women. You all truly exemplify this goal. You didn't become who you are following a well-worn, beaten path. You worked hard and have truly forged a path for others. Your stories, reflections, and lives remind me of a quote from Madeleine Albright. She said, "It took me a long time to develop a voice, and now that I have one, I'm not going to be silenced." You are not silent. You are being heard. You are remarkable.
We know you don't do it for credit or glory. You're often in the shadows. Sometimes your amazing work is overlooked, but not tonight. Tonight, the spotlight is on you and the stars are talking about you.
Born into a real-life Hollywood dynasty, but actress, singer, author, and advocate Jolie Fisher is far more than just a name.
Being a boss as well, you know, I think I'm not a shrinking violet, as you can tell. I was raised by a woman who's sexy, sex kitten icon, 60s, whatever, and she was all of that, but she had very old-fashioned values. My story is like all of your story, you know? It's just we were under a microscope.
Your life has been beautifully bizarre.
I had an awakening of life is short.
Amen.
And I'm going to reimagine, redefine, reinvent as a woman of a certain age, like moving forward. So I'm a creative force. I'm that mom. I am a lioness.
There are 112 women here who are the best of the best. How important is it that we recognize this work?
Oh my gosh, your stories are so important. Like, we're here for a little short visit. Like, take the space, be who you are, make decisions about what you want to represent. And I know, I've heard lots of your stories, and I know that you represent just goodness and kindness and powerhouse women. And I'm just so proud to be a part of this.
Coming up, 112 of America's most remarkable women honored in Hollywood by today's biggest stars. Who will be Nexstar's next Remarkable Woman of the Year? women changing the world one community at a time. Who is Nexstar's Remarkable Woman of the Year? Find out coming up.
Magical night for all of us tonight. And who agrees with this lady? Who agrees with the bedazzling Brooke Burke?
Yes.
When the TV host, author, and entrepreneur says, there's something magical about a woman who feels comfortable in her own skin. I'm agreeing. Brooke holds many remarkable titles, but the busy Miss Burke broke away just to celebrate each of you, Brooke Burke. Brooke brought the next generation. Introduce Sierra.
This is Sierra Sky, number two in the lineup of four daughters and two young boys.
So glad that you're here.
I'm so lucky to have a mom that's always encouraged me to only be myself and not have to fit in anybody else's shoes but my own.
I mean, I think we have a tremendous responsibility as women. I was raised by a very strong mother, which is a blessing, and I know not everybody was born into that, but I have the tremendous responsibility of raising fearless young girls that know what freedom is and that have the right to be who they are and the right Amen. To change and the right to pivot and the right to take chances and the right to express themselves. And I guess the one bit of advice that I would give is find your purpose, find your passion, live a purposeful life. Like, that's my wish for my children.
So So we're spending a lot of time honoring women, which is why we're here, but how about we take just a second and do a little shout out to the remarkable men in our lives? Are we good with that? All right.
Hey, Mickey Dolenz of the Monkees here, and I am a believer in remarkable women. Really strong women, capable, educated, strong characters, strong personalities.
I think women are just remarkable on their own, and I've been lucky enough to be sort of raised and shaped by some pretty remarkable women.
My mother, my aunts, my cousins, I was raised predominantly around women, and they've never stopped being an inspiration for me.
Congratulations to all this year's winners.
You know, there are some people who make their actions count by standing up for things that matter. And when they are Kevin Frazier from Entertainment Tonight, they use that platform to become one of today's greatest allies. You've interviewed all the remarkable ladies. Who stands out on that list?
You think immediately the big ones, Beyonce and J-Lo, but there are also those women who along the way have changed the face of this country. I get to travel the world in my job. I always like to meet people in different locales. That is one of the reasons why we started this new travel platform called Sepia, because there are so many hidden figures out there.
In your personal life though, there must be those special ones who keep you grounded and remind you that you don't know anything.
My wife, she is the deputy director of the Trone Center for Racial Justice for the ACLU. My great aunt, a woman named Septima Poinsett Clark, and she was a teacher in South Carolina. And she was fired for joining the NAACP. Like many of you, she didn't pout, she picked up. And she kept moving. And she went to Tennessee and she started a thing called the Highlander School with Ella Baker. And they trained people so they could learn how to vote, so that they could learn civil disobedience in a peaceful manner. And one of the first people they ever trained was a woman who became her lifelong friend, Rosa Parks.
I'd like your optics on that quintessential question about, can men and women really have it all?
You can have it all. But you have to learn and listen. Greatest lesson I've learned, just do whatever you love. Like our good friend Sheila E. says, follow the beat of your own drum. Lisa and DJ Miss Ninja, can you do me a favor? Can you give me a little bit of a drum roll?
Yes, that's right. I want you all to make some noise, because it's true. Please say hello to the woman, the legend herself, Sheila E. in the house for Remarkable Women.
You have played all around the world in some really memorable nights. Is there one or even two that stick out?
The first one, when I was 15, I wasn't going to be a percussionist. So I was training to be in the Olympics. I was in track and field.
Played. I'm not going to race you. No, I'm
no
not,
you don't want to race me.
No.
I'll hurt you. But that one show that I did with my dad at 15 just changed my life.
You've been famous forever and a day, but you're famous for encouraging a lot of other women.
Well, my mom is the rock of the family, so having a strong woman in my life, my mom, my grandmothers, they instilled in us to continue to just give and constantly give and encourage people.
Knowing who these women are, knowing what this is about, what do you say to them?
You've already done so much.
Yes.
I just want to encourage you to keep doing what you're doing, because we need, everyone in this room is so powerful. I know it's hard, sometimes you feel like you're alone, but you're not.
This new album, Let's Talk Salsa.
Ooh, yes.
Let's talk, you have a new salsa album. Tell me about it, Valar.
First ever salsa record I've done in my career thus far. I don't know what took me so long, but I have a huge bucket list that I just keep checking things off.
Now, the moment we have been waiting for.
Who will be named Nexstar's next Remarkable Woman of the Year? 2024's five finalists are From Houston, Texas, Tammy Lang Campbell. Born in the Bronx, New York, Geraldine Rodriguez. Donna Lee Reed calls Charlotte, North Carolina home. Heidi Fireherm Smith is from Salina, Kansas. And living in Los Angeles, California, Anna Estevez. Congratulations and thank you for all you do.
There's a lot of work to be done. There's a lot of injustice happening on a daily basis.
College, community, corporate, church, together we win for our young people.
We don't just fund our Monkey in My Chair program, but we also help families financially.
I want to be successful and I want to stay to give back to my community.
I am a remarkable woman.
Nexstar's Remarkable Woman of the Year is Geraldine Rodriguez from the Bronx, New York.
You and Cher were holding this great big check. What are you doing with that?
Oh my goodness. So this year, because we turned 10, we are launching a multi-year fundraiser just so that we can keep growing and keep serving more young people.
The last couple of days, how has that felt for you just to be in this space with all of these women?
I literally feel like my cup is overflowing in a good way, you know, for real. I feel like I'm about to leave with 111 sisters.
We have this moment together, Cher, I think, to say congratulations to all of you and to the top five finalists. But this is a moment to really bring it home, I think, for Geraldine, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. One, two, three.
Geraldine, you are remarkable.
Thank you for watching and celebrating Nexstar's Remarkable Women. From the city where dreams come true, don't ever give up on yours.
Thank you.